a weight of 15 newton is suspended by a spring. So we have a weight of 15 newton suspended by a spring, 15 newton, and then the stiffness of the spring is 2 newton per millimeter. You are to determine the natural frequency of the free vibration of the system. So of course, natural frequency, we have expressed it F. Note that there is a difference between the, when we say natural frequency, generally we are talking of F. If you do not specifically say angular frequency, then we are talking of F. So F, we have the expression, you substitute your values. The acceleration due to gravity G is given, and this gives us 5.76 hertz. Example number two, calculate the natural angular frequency for the frame shown in the next figure. Also calculate the natural period of vibration, and then you are given the initial condition, displacement and velocity. So you ask what is the amplitude and displacement at t is equals to 1 second. So you are to take EI is equals to 30 times 10 to the power 12 newton per millimeter cubed, newton millimeter cubed. This one, of course, because we said the frame, for the frame, for our case now, we are considering a very rigid beam. Even though I have not said it, this EI is for the quorum. For the beam, EI is quite large. So we said it's generally infinite. But remember, not all cases that this one have to be rigid. For our case now, here we are just considering it to be rigid. So this is the frame we have here, quorum A, B, C, D, and then the girder having a mass 3 times 10 to the power 6 newton as BC. Of course, now the restoring force is provided by the spring. So you see, we say this quorum can be represented by spring. So we have a spring there and another spring here. So you can get the equivalent spring constant because these are spring in parallel. A case for spring in series would be whereby we have a multi-story building. We have a multi-story building like that. Then we have, this is the first spring. We have another spring. We have another spring here. So in this case now, this would be spring in series. But this would be spring in series, while from this column to this side will be spring in parallel. So this is now the equivalent spring constant. Now you can go ahead and calculate the angular frequency. It's given by this equation. So what we are being tested here is whether you are able to calculate the angular, the spring, equivalent spring constant. Then natural period, of course, you have the expression, very easy. Period is the reciprocal of the natural frequency. And now we want to calculate the amplitude at t is equals to 1. So we are solving the initial Fourier problem, IVP, using the initial condition. So remember equation 21 and 23 we gave previously, 21, this one, 23, and also equation, actually it's equation 20, not 21, we are using this. So we said equation 16, the solution can be expressed as shown by this in compact form. We are using this, U can be expressed in compact form as shown. So at T is equals to zero, the initial condition null, displacement is 25 millimeter and velocity is 25 millimeters per second. So using our equation to amplitude can be given by that expression here, and the phase angle is as shown. At t is equals to 1 second, now using this expression, then you have, you just need to replace now, because you have found the values of A and beta, you just need to replace and you get displacement is equals to 24.2. So you see, we are starting at initial displacement of 25 millimeters. So what does this mean? Initially, for the displacement to occur, this structure is deformed 25 millimeter and then it's released. So at 1 second, we want to see what is the displacement. So it's going back to its initial, the original position. That's why you find that the value that you have computed here is less than the initial, because now we have released our structure.